In this video, we will give an overview of our BQ76942 and BQ76952 family of products. This is our newest industrial battery monitor family, which includes integrated high-side drivers, integrated protection, and cell balancing. Let's go over some of the key features. For battery monitoring, the devices measure voltage, current, and temperature. The devices have an integrated coulomb counter that does the current integration, so a microcontroller is not needed to do the integration. There are several protections: over and under voltage, over and under temperature during charge and discharge, over temperature for the FET, open wire, short circuit, multiple levels of overcurrent during discharge, overcurrent during charge, cell imbalance, watchdog, and more. The devices also include some other diagnostic functions. There are also secondary protections. For serious problems, the device can shut down FETs or even blow a fuse. The FET drivers are high-side end FETs. There is a charge pump with an external capacitor, so it can be used for large FET loads. For cell balancing, there is integrated passive cell balancing up to 50 milliamps per cell and support for external passive balancing using either FETs or BJTs. The device can do manual balancing, where the MCU does all control, or it can operate fully autonomously. There is support for pre-charge and pre-discharge modes using high-side PFETs. There are two LDOs that can be configured to different voltages, up to 45 milliamps each. There is support for I2C, SPI, with or without CRC, or HDQ. The devices are high voltage tolerant with an 85 volt ABS max on high voltage pins. This helps to support random cell connection order. Protection recovery can be fully autonomous or host controlled. The devices have very good measurement accuracy. The ADT accuracy is 10 millivolts over a 0 to 60 C range. The devices have fast data refresh rate. The refresh rate is determined by the number of cell voltages and the number of thermistors measured, as well as the ADC speed setting. As mentioned, the devices offer synchronized voltage and current measurement, and the coulomb counter measures current constantly and performs the integration internally. There are multiple power modes for optimized power usage. There is normal mode, which has all measurements running very fast, sleep mode, where the protections are running but measurements are at a less frequent interval. This is programmable. The devices jump between normal and sleep mode based on current flow. There is deep sleep mode, which only keeps the MCU alive. There are no measurements, no protections, and FETs are off. Regulators 1 and 2 can stay powered up. And then shutdown mode, which draws only about 1 microamp of current, and everything is powered down. There are two ways to wake up from shutdown. All total, the device includes lots of integration to keep the system efficient and low cost. There are integrated high-side drivers, so the system can communicate when FETs are off, so there is no need for isolation for the comms. There are two LDOs to support the MCU or circuitry inside the pack. Here is a high-level block diagram of the BQ76942. On the left side are the input pins, with a MUX going into the ADC and a MUX going into the overvoltage, undervoltage, and open wire detection block. In the bottom corner, the cell balancing switches, the coulomb counter, sense resistor inputs, and also a comparator for the current protections. Up top shows the LDOs. On the right are the drivers for fuse, charge and discharge protection FETs, P-charge and P-discharge FETs, and the digital pins, including the communications. The BQ76952 is very similar. It just includes a larger number of cell inputs. Let's take a look at the basic schematic for the BQ76952, the 16S device. You can see we have cells, RC connections, sense resistor, thermistors, and the digital connections. There are two regulators. One can be for the MCU, and one can be for other circuitry like transceiver. The regulator block uses an external BJT. It draws current. The BREG pin controls the base so that the emitter is approximately 5.5 volts, and then current flows in here and out of the regulators. This is the discharge and charge FET. This is the high current path. There is another video in which we'll discuss the protection FET configuration options in much more detail. And then here we have the PFETs with the resistors for the pre-charge mode and pre-discharge mode. The device can also drive a fuse signal together with a secondary protector, so if redundant protection is needed, both can drive the fuse and disable the pack. The device has integrated cell balance FETs that can support up to around 50 milliamps of cell balance current. The device also supports random cell attach, so cells do not have to be connected in order. The D-charge and D-discharge pins are logic level FET outputs. These signals can be used to drive an external driver. We have dedicated pins to turn off FETs very fast. If the MCU decides that there is some problem and wants to turn off FETs, it can use the CFETOff and DFETOff pins to shut off the FETs very quickly and does not have to go through the communications. And here we have the I2C connections to the MCU, which can also be SPI or HDQ. This image describes the power modes in a little more detail. It shows the current consumption, the features that are enabled, and the system benefit. Here's a little more detail on the LDOs. Reg 1 and Reg 2 are identical. The current comes from a top of stack through a BJT off chip and then goes on chip through the drivers for Reg 1 and Reg 2. Each is programmable from 1.8 volts to 5 volts. A DC to DC converter can also be used off chip for improved efficiency. We will not go over all of the protection features in this video, but I will give a very brief overview of the protection features offered by the BQ76942 and BQ76952 devices. Each protection feature is highly configurable. For example, you can see that the thresholds and delays can be programmed for each protection feature. Protections can be mapped to the alert pin of the device to serve as an interrupt to the MCU, and all of the device settings are OTP programmable if you need to modify the default settings at power up to avoid writing the settings with the MCU. Here we show the voltage and current protections. And here, we can see the various temperature protections as well as the host watchdog and pre-charge timeout protections. There are also many secondary protection features which can be used to disable the pack in the event of a more serious event. Many are listed here, but the full list is available in the device documentation. That covers the high-level overview of the BQ76942 and BQ76952. Thanks for watching!